What emotion triggers adrenaline? Can you guess? Fear. Fear triggers adrenaline. So does exercise, excitement, physical threat, and hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, can all trigger adrenaline. Now let's take a look at what adrenaline does. It increases your heart rate, sweating, vasodilation of both the lung tissue so you can breathe better, as well as the heart. The coronary artery vasodilates when there's adrenaline, getting more oxygen and blood to the heart and muscle tissue. This is one of the reasons why you probably have seen movies where they've injected someone into the heart with adrenaline to revive them. Adrenaline makes your body stronger, more alert, because it's part of the flight or fight mechanism. You're being chased by a tiger, right? It releases glucose from your liver and your muscles for quick energy. And it triggers this other hormone right here, which relates to something called the HPA axis, the hypothalamus, pituitary, and adrenal axis. This is a little different mechanism where you're increasing cortisol, which is the other stress hormone. So both adrenaline and cortisol are preparing the body for a stress state. The difference is adrenaline is what within seconds. Cortisol takes a few minutes to kick in. Cortisol is more long-lasting. Adrenaline is more short-lived. Now, I'll never forget, when I was in wrestling, I wrestled in 9th grade, 10th grade, 11th grade, 12th grade, in the first year of college until I fractured my neck. But in high school, I wrestled at 185 pounds, which, by the way, that's actually my weight right now. But there was only one more weight class above this, which is heavyweight. So when we had a meet, I would literally have to wait for all these wrestlers to wrestle before it was my opportunity. And so there was a lot of excitement. There was a lot of fear going on. I remember trying to relax and rest underneath the bleachers before the match because I literally had to wait probably, I don't know, an hour and a half before I wrestled. And so I was laying there and I felt my heart rate beating through my chest, just boom, 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 boom. I was sweating. I had a lot of energy flowing through my body. So I was not about to take a nap. I was not about to feel calm. I was basically in an adrenaline mode for about an hour and a half. And so what happened, that drained my energy. So by the time I was ready to wrestle, I was completely exhausted, but somehow I pushed through it. So short-term adrenaline is good. Chronic exposure to too much adrenaline is very, very bad because it burns you out. It can burn out the adrenals. It can affect the heart. It can affect your mood. You can actually have a lower tolerance for stress. It can actually prevent you from going into a relaxing sleep if there's a little too much adrenaline flowing through your body. Here's the thing with adrenaline. Adrenaline is made by the inside of your adrenals called the adrenal medulla. And this adrenaline, which is a neurotransmitter, it's like a hormone, but it travels through the nervous system, is part of the sympathetic nervous system. It's kind of like the on switch to stress. The off switch, which is called the parasympathetic, is not in the adrenals. So the unique thing about the adrenals, it's 100% sympathetic nervous system, and there's no parasympathetic innervation in the inside of the adrenal. In other words, there's no off switch. And so if you chronically stimulate the adrenals with any of these over a period of time, the adrenals tend to stay on and they don't turn off that well. And so here you are, you can't sleep, you can't relax, you feel stressed all the time, and then that's going to activate more cortisol and then you get belly fat. So the question is, what can you do about it? This is really not a nutritional problem. This is a stress problem. So you need to disconnect from the stress or somehow handle the stress, whatever that stress is. If it's certain groups of people or a person, you need to handle that. That includes turning off the TV so you're not watching the news every night, changing your environment, sleeping more. There's some really good, important nutritional things you can do to help, but without handling this right here, these really won't create a big impact. But vitamin B1 is at the top of the list. If you take B1 or nutritional yeast, you're going to feel a sense of relief. Vitamin D, vitally important. And vitamin C, because your adrenals need vitamin C, both adrenaline and cortisol. Without vitamin C, your adrenal glands do not work. But let me come back to this little point right here, hypoglycemia. Now, what causes hypoglycemia? What has the capacity to push your blood sugars down? And the answer to that is insulin. And what triggers that? You guessed it, a high carbohydrate diet. Being on a high carbohydrate diet keeps your body in flight or fight mode, activating adrenaline and creating a situation where it's going to be really hard to lose weight. So just by changing your diet, going on a low carb diet, guess what can happen? You can help to restore normal levels of adrenaline. And this is why when people do the keto diet, they feel calmer, they feel less stressed. If you're new to my channel, I put a link down below of exactly what you should be eating. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.